just to get it for the low. I'm from Dago, Paletero on my block. I'm from Dago. Small configuration, this shit fuego.
Cortez on my feet, call me Diego. Shoelaces clean like the fuego. From where your baby mama for the peso. No job, but I'm still on payroll. Fresh out of jail, I beat the charges. Really from SD, don't ask me how I feel about the Chargers.
Alright guys, Chiba here. We're here at the hangar for a special Bridge Mercado event. We got a few heads showing up already. It's still a little early, but I'm going to show you guys the football boutique.
Nice to meet you, man. So what inspired you to come up with this idea of football boutique?
So I got inspired because I had a brand myself. I was doing a streetwear like soccer brand, and I saw all the brands out there, and so I was a fan of all of them, and I thought, well, why don't we just bring them all together under one roof? And that's how the concept of the football boutique came about.
And what's your goal for this business idea that you have? Where do you hope to be at in the next couple years?
The biggest goal is to do this cross country. So take the trailer, take the boutique, cross country, hit up all the big like major soccer cities, and set up for, you know, a cross country tour.
And have you reached out to maybe like other teams, MLS teams or anything, to maybe set up like in a parking lot or something like that?
Yeah, we've definitely reached out. So we've already worked with Galaxy and LAFC. We're here in LA, so that was easy. But yeah, we started getting contacts in Atlanta, in Austin, Chicago, in Portland. So we're gonna, yeah, try to put all those things together and make one big trip.
If you guys haven't done so, make sure you guys follow the Football Boutique on Instagram.
Welcome to the hair, guys. Thank you for coming out to this morning. Representing DJ Knock in the house. Here we go, guys. Make it happen.
What started this whole event? You've been promoting it for a while already, so
yeah.
How did this all come about?
So Football Boutique, they messaged us and they're like, hey, want to come out one time? So I was like, okay, we'll try to do our next pop-up. So we could have done it at a park, but then I thought it would be better to like try it in this new spot, the hangar. So it's a little bit more controlled and we didn't have to worry about permits and all that stuff. So that's what happened. So we called up the hangar, they said they're down with it, and then here we are.
Now, I'm assuming you're in the Loyal game tonight. What's your score prediction for tonight?
I'm thinking like a 2-0.
What's up, guys? It's Chiba. I'm here for the San Diego Loyal versus Sacramento game. It's one of the last few home games that San Diego Loyal has. I am a little bit late. Don't tell Tony that. He's going to see this either way. But San Diego Loyal has their lineup already. And on goal, it's Austin Guerrero. On left back, it's going to be Colin Montgomery. Then you got Yato and Stoneman again on center back. Elijah Martin's probably going to play right back again, which he did great against Los Dos. Then you got Colin Martin. Surprise, Charlie Adams is on the bench after scoring last game, last week. But, you know, squad rotations want to give him some rest. Then you're going to have Guido along with Colin Martin in the center mid. You're going to have Ibarra. And you got the new guy getting his first start, Blake Bodily, getting his first start over on the wing. You also got Toomey. And then you got Corey Hertzog on top. No Augie this game. How's it going? No Augie this game, just he's on international break, helping out Sierra Leone. It's still a solid lineup. I'm expecting a lot from San Diego Loyal. I am expecting a 2-0, 2-1 win. I'm hoping Elijah has a great game. He did last time, so it should be a fun one.
Defender number 14, Josh.
All right, guys, the atmosphere is freaking amazing right now.
crazy. I got another camera that is gonna be the locals camera now. The locals, that's what I'm gonna call it. It looks like a packed house, but they were not kidding when they said they sold over 5,000 tickets tonight. It is a big game, especially to secure that second position on the table. The game begins, and I'll keep you guys posted with updates throughout the game, guys. Which is honestly what I expected. I didn't think Loyola was going to be scoring so many goals today. Although it's still too early to call, but without Augie, who has been the main guy on top, it's going to be hard. Herzog was not, he's not a striker. He's not. He's a center forward. He plays a little better, a little behind the striker. And he has that same old role this time, so let's see if he can adapt to it and get back to it. I don't think I've seen Torreo this packed since like the first game of the season, from this season and last season. I'm amazed at how packed it is. I think that's what happens when the Padres are out of playoffs. And oh shit. A few more people are giving Loyola a chance. Oh, it's away! La Manola no. A la madre. This is a shout out to Elijah Martin. Eres un crack, cabrón. Eres un crack. Someone translate that to him whenever you see him. This guy can play left back, right back, left mid. This guy, he's probably top five key players in San Diego Loyola. Absolutely. Without a doubt in my mind. And there's no presence inside the box for San Diego Loyola. And that's the absence of Augie Williams. I'm telling you guys, Corey Herzog is not a, he's not a striker. He's a center forward, false nine, whatever you want to call it. The chemistry's not all the way there with the new guy on the left wing, man. He's missed a couple passes already. You can tell that he's still catching up to San Diego Loyola's game plan and strategy. Well, Herzog gave a blue ball to the box, but he's a striker. There's no one on top of him. That's the problem to this game. Sacramento, something's gotta get done, man. Something's gotta get done. Oh man, Stoneman just got. Oh man, Stoneman pushed up a little too much. Got beat off with speed. That's unfortunate for sure. Wow, San Diego usually gets scored on pretty luckily. This time, defensive mistake as I was just praising the defense. And a corner kick was finally headed on target by Callum Montgomery. Again, nothing too much on the header. He had to dive for it. Goalkeeper caught it with a lot of ease. The most dangerous San Diego Loyola plays have been pretty easy for the goalkeeper so far. And Sacramento has had maybe one good chance, and that was their goal. And it was off a counterattack. So San Diego Loyola are dominating this game in possession, but possession does not win the game. So there should be some yellow cards out. Let's see what happened. Toomey fouled. And this guy pushed Toomey, that should be a yellow card. Colin Barton pushed his ass back. And then he tripped over Toomey, his clone player pulled him down. This is fucking hilarious. His own player pulled him down. So I think it's number 66. Like a weird ass number, that should be getting a yellow card. I guess Colin deserves a yellow too. Yeah, I think he's gonna take a yellow card to Colin. Pushing, give it to the other guy too.
This is the guy up here that talks all so much shit to the goalkeeper. We got the first substitution of the game. We got Douglas Martinez coming in for Colin Montgomery. I don't know how he's gonna stand.
And Douglas Martinez Jr. for Colin Montgomery at minute 53.
Douglas is on the right wing. Ibarra moved over to the left. It's either Blake Bodley or Ibarra. It looks like it's gonna be Ibarra playing left back.
For Herzog, leave it for Guido. Long range! Guido strikes!
Guido with the shot on the left bottom corner. Goalkeeper couldn't reach it. And he does a little dance like he likes to do when he celebrates and scores a goal. Guido's back on the score sheet again, number 10. What a freaking shot, man. What a goal. It's tied up in the 54th minute. It's a great time to be a fan here at Torreón. Chip hit the post, almost freaking golazo by Herzog. Daniel Loyola has all the momentum right now. Sacramento's scared, they don't know what to do. You see the defender asking the players to settle down. Man, I would have been a freaking beauty if Herzog scores that.
The cohesion that's built all season, players knowing where other players are going to be, the strengths, who can hit that first time ball.
There he is again, Guido at midfield. Options ahead, springs it for Martinez, off the left side, Martinez, and San Diego's ahead!
Herzog almost pulling a nice cheeky move in the box. They call for a penalty. Referee said no. San Diego has all the momentum right now. They should be scoring another goal soon. Man, this is amazing. Over 6,000 fans in the stadium. It was a sellout. Wow. That's amazing to see, man. San Diego Loyola growing a lot in San Diego. And hopefully soccer grows as a whole in San Diego. That's what we want to see. That's why we started this podcast, too. Put the word out there for local soccer as well. overall right now, San Diego is just absolutely dominating. There's nothing Sacramento can do right now. And it's a beautiful thing to watch.
Landon Douglas Martinez coming off the bench again some minutes after being out, I believe, two games. How was his impact on the game, even though he came off due to an injury as well?
He was fantastic, and his training was very good this week. He looked confident, aggressive, and then he got the goal that won the game. So I'm very happy for him. Really sad he had to come out of the game. He got a kind of like a dead leg and had to come out, but he was phenomenal and gave us a huge impact.
And what is it like having that depth where you're able to rest Charlie Adams for part of the game and then still counting on your players to dominate?
Yeah, listen, we've grown a lot this year, and we've grown in using a lot of guys in a lot of different roles. So Ollie LaRaz has been out for a while now. Charlie couldn't go tonight from the start. Douglas has been out a little bit. Augustine Williams has gone on international duty. Jack Blake's been out a long time. Jack Metcalf's been out a long time. I'm sure any other USL team that had that many guys out doesn't win that game tonight. But our guys really dig deep, and whoever's called on steps up and does their job. And so really proud of these guys.
He's for you. Cool. Alejandro Guido.
Guido, what was that conversation at halftime with Landon and the players being down 1-0?
It was really positive. He said that we were doing great. Just that loss of concentration that we had. But to keep on believing, to keep on playing our football, and yeah, that's what we actually did in the second half.
You know, with some key players out in the starting lineup, obviously, what is it like adapting to different positions and different roles for you?
Right. For sure. Luckily, we have a really good squad and depth, and we were able to, you know, play good football, even though maybe one of like our star players or two or three that were out. But other than that, I was really happy with the team performance, and I think the team was overall happy as well.
Mm-hmm. And then celebrating a goal with a sold-out stadium, what's that feeling like?
That was really special. I'm going to remember that the rest of my life, and I hope we can do many more, and hopefully we can do that in a playoff.
All right, guys, 2-1 win for San Diego Loyal. I got to talk to Landon, got to talk to Guido a little bit. It was a great result. This pretty much clinches playoffs for San Diego Loyal as I'm passing through some loud-ass light. This clinches playoffs for San Diego Loyal, and Danlin said it. The objective is to get the home playoff match. With Orange County losing 4-1 today, that's pretty much a possibility for sure now. And the team's playing great without some of the key players, which is amazing. San Diego Loyal just dominated the second half. They had that momentum early in the first 10 minutes of the second half, and they capitalized on all of their chances that they had, and they came out with a nice win, man. Great day to be a San Diego Loyal supporter. And shout out to Travis for that tequila growler for Guido. He fucking loved it. Everyone loved it. Good shit, Travis. Chiva signing out. Make sure you guys like, share, and subscribe. Appreciate the shit out of every single one of you. Thank you.